Hello and good evening students. How are you all? I hope that you must be taking benefit of online teaching and doing your studies and assignment well. So, in the last period, we have studied the definition of noun. So, again I am repeating the definition of noun for you, and that is, noun is a name of a person, place, animal, things, feelings and thoughts. So students, today we are going to study about the types of noun. Now, do you know there are four types of noun? They are the main four types of noun. And here, I am writing the types of nouns. First one is common noun. Second one is proper noun. Third one is collective noun. And fourth one is abstract noun. Study about the common noun. So, common nouns are the names that are given in general to the people, places, things and animals. For example, if we are talking about a boy, so boy represents the whole class of the boys. If we are talking about a cat, cat is a word that represents the whole class of cats. So, these are the common nouns. Now I am writing here types of noun. First one is common noun. And example of common noun are cat, city, bird, village. River. So these are the examples of the common noun. So second one is proper noun. So students, you know that proper nouns are the special name of the persons, places, and they are the particular names of person and places. Now, think that we are sitting in a class and I want to call one girl or boy. So, I will call here, Riya, can you stand up? So, among all that students, only Riya will stand up. So, Riya is a proper noun. Then, students, we are living in a city and the name of the city is Manmad. So, Manmad is also a special noun. Sorry, proper noun. So, Manmad is also a proper noun. Like this, Mount Everest. Then, students, you know that we are suffering from today from a dangerous disease like COVID-19. And we have get it from China. And China is also a proper noun. Then river Ganga. Ganga river. Then Mount Everest. Proper nouns. So students, now we are going to study collective nouns. So Collective nouns, they are the names of group of people, things, places, etc. So, collective nouns are taken together and they are spoken as a whole. They are the name of collection of people, things, places or places or things. Now, for example, a star of teachers. A fleet of ships. So these are the two sentences. In first, I have written here a staff of teachers. So here, staff is a word that represents the whole group of teachers, and the word fleet is a word that represents a whole group of ships. So these are the collective nouns. Then fourth one is abstract noun. Now, first of all, you have to know the meaning of the abstract. Abstract means the things that we cannot see, we cannot touch, but we can feel it through our senses. So, abstract nouns, examples are bravery, wisdom. So these are the example of abstract nouns. Now students, we can form many abstract nouns by using the different words. For example, I am writing here abstract nouns can be formed by adjectives. Now, first one is form with adjectives. And which are they? For example, brave, bravery, high, height. Then second one is adjective form with the help of the verbs. For example, no, knowledge, then judge, judgment, then abstract nouns can be formed with the help of common nouns. Third one, form with common nouns. For example, childhood. Then play,
slavery. Then by adding T I O N. Next one is by adding T I O N. In the last, this word comes T I O N. For example, act becomes action. Attract. Attraction. Like this. Then by adding M E N T. By adding M E N T. For example, appoint. Appointment. Punish. You know that when you are doing some mischief, teacher used to punish you, and we can form abstract word from that punishment. Then adding ly. By adding L Y. In the last, that this word comes. Sorry, I T Y. I T Y. For example, real, reality. Then moral. Morality. So like this, we can form abstract noun from various ways. Now, up to now we have seen the four main types of nouns. First one is common noun, second one is proper noun, third one is collective noun, fourth one is abstract noun. Apart from that, there are two types of nouns, and they are countable nouns and uncountable nouns. Students, listen carefully. There are four main types, but these two are also included in that. So one is countable noun, and second is uncountable noun. Now students, first we are going to see countable noun. As you know that countable nouns, that are the things that we can count. 1, 2, 3 like this. Or the things that can be counted. So, for countable nouns, we use numbers. For example, flowers, fingers, notebooks, pencils, etc. And when we are using countable nouns, at that time we can use numbers with them, and we can write like this: 5 fingers. 2 notebooks. 4 pencils. keep in mind that all the common nouns are the countable nouns. Now we are moving towards the uncountable nouns. Second one is uncountable nouns. Now students, as you know that countable means that we can count, and uncountable means that we cannot count, or the things that cannot be counted. For example, milk, sugar, petrol, homework, dirt. Now the examples of uncountable noun I am writing here. For example, how can we write it? I drink plenty of milk. Then you have a lot of homework. Fill up some petrol. Now students, keep in mind that we cannot use numbers for uncountable nouns. So instead of that, we have to use the phrases of quantity. For example, I have used here plenty of, then a lot of, some. So these are the phrases of quantity. So again, I am writing here some examples. 4 kilos of rice. 2 sacks of sugar. 4 kilos So we can write like this: 4 kilos of rice, 2 sacks of sugar. So we have to use the numbers with the uncountable nouns. And uncountable nouns never change their form, or we cannot add s to the uncountable nouns. And one more thing I want to tell you, that we never add a before uncountable nouns. For example, we never say like this. We never say or write a sand, then a bowl, a water. So it is not the proper way to write the uncountable noun. Means we never use a before uncountable nouns. So this is the wrong way to write down the uncountable nouns. I hope that up to now you have understood all the types of nouns: common noun, proper noun, abstract noun, collective noun, countable noun, uncountable noun. So after this, I am giving you an assignment, that is the question number K in your textbook, Ashley's birthday party. And 1 minute. On page number 17, 19. The question is given. Ashley had invited all her friends to her birthday party. They had a wonderful time. And Ashley's friend Sophia described the party to her mother. And some words are missing in this description. And that words you have to write down here. And this is your assignment of these nouns. So here our first lesson is finished. Also, you have to do question number F, G and H. I am writing here homework or you can say assignment. Question number F, G, H. This you have to write down in your homework. And also along with this you have to write down question number K. So all these questions are for your homework. I hope that you have understood the types of nouns, the definition of noun. And till then, good day, goodbye, see you again. Stay home and stay safe. Thank you.